which signs commence a new lunar year. This is so simple, folks, I assure you, and it is not what you have been told. Might an equinox alone begin a lunar year? Some say a lunar year begins after the equinox. I live very near the equator, and the sun has passed over our heads and moved to the south approximately 3 months ago. Britannica Encyclopedia says, an equinox occurs when the position of the sun is exactly over the equator. If you live where I do, you will notice exactly when the equinox occurs. However, what if you live in the northern United States or anywhere on Earth with a northern latitude? How is it you are going to know the exact day the equinox occurs at the equator when you are so far north from it? The further north, the more incorrect your observation will be. Being off by one day near a new moon makes a big difference. Please do not tell me you will simply look at the NASA website, time and date, or elsewhere on the computer. Please do not rely on someone else to tell you this information. Rather, look into the heavens and understand its signs. Some believe the crescent moon tells you when the equinox occurs, thus, when a year begins as it will appear as the shape of a bowl, or it takes on the shape as the horns of a bull. Again, this display is more so at the equator. The FVC moon takes on this bull, or bullhorn-shaped moon most every month. Mainly because many refuse to actually look into the heavens and learn the stars, they begin relying on those fabricating calendars a year in advance. If Moses did not use them, neither should you. Life can be distracting, keeping us from making memories of each moment Yahuwah provides today. One problem leads to another, then this or that demands our attention. Soon the importance of life and family takes a backseat and later never comes. Today, stop and smell the roses, get outside, look into the heavens, and learn His ways. Matthew 6:34, therefore, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about itself. Each day has enough trouble of its own. Some say, look for a small star near the hand of a woman Scripture has named Virgo while the moon is at her feet. All this while a bright moon shines in the foreground, making it impossible for the star to be visible. This woman of Revelation 12 describes events leading to the third woe. The verses have nothing to do with the beginning of a new lunar year. Scripture contains zero descriptive dialogue endorsing this woman as being a symbol for the beginning of a lunar year. In fact, observations demonstrate the full moon is not under the woman's feet to begin a new year every year. Many times it is at or above her head, and other times it is well below her feet during the natural cycles of the full moon. Problems with that are as follows. 1. It is near impossible to see this little star because the vicinity of the moon blocks it out, so should we break out the tablet to locate it? I am sure that is not part of the Creator's plan. Secondly, there would be only a handful alive today who could identify this cluster of stars if it were not for the artwork of man. Our Creator did not place the artwork there. In fact, we are commanded to not have those images before us, at least so says number 2. 3. The wise men of old, they learned only the stars, they did not use man's pagan images which go against his commandments, nor did they use the lines, but only the stars of the heavens. Some will claim these are not graven images of stone, instead they are pictorial images. All I can do is shake my head. A single star in Virgo is by no means a qualifying factor for the beginning of a new lunar year. Why are few promoting the Queen of Heaven? Who is this Queen of Heaven some promote to commence a year? Today the Roman Catholic Church views their Blessed Virgin Mary clothed with the sun as this woman of Revelation 12. As we look deeper into her past, reference to Assyrian, the Babylonian goddess called Ishtar, also referred to as Astarte or Ashtoreth. The goddesses of Babylonian Ishtar, is the wife of the false god Baal/Moloch. This is the wife of a chief male deity in Babylonian pagan worship cultures, thus Ishtar is accredited to the name Queen of Heaven. Scripture speaks strongly against this Queen of Heaven. 1. Jeremiah 7:18. The children gather wood, and the fathers kindle the fire, and the women knead their dough, to make cakes to the Queen of Heaven, and to pour out drink offerings unto other gods, that they may provoke me to anger. 2. Jeremiah 44:17. But we will certainly do whatsoever thing goeth forth out of our own mouth, to burn incense unto the Queen of Heaven, and to pour out drink offerings unto her, as we have done, we, and our fathers, our kings, and our princes, in the cities of Judah, and in the streets of Jerusalem, for then had we plenty of victuals, and were well, and saw no evil. 18 But since we left off to burn incense to the Queen of Heaven, and to pour out drink offerings unto her, we have wanted all things, and have been consumed by the sword and by the famine. 19 And when we burned incense to the Queen of Heaven, and poured out drink offerings unto her, did we make her cakes to worship her, and pour out drink offerings unto her, without our men? Here the Queen of Heaven was a foreign god the Israelites worshipped in direct opposition to the laws of Yahuwah. Jeremiah 44:25. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, saying, Ye and your wives have both spoken with your mouths, and fulfilled with your hand, saying, We will surely perform our vows that we have vowed, to burn incense to the Queen of Heaven, and to pour out drink offerings unto her. Ye will surely accomplish your vows, and surely perform your vows. Torah commandments are clear, we are to worship only Yahuwah. The worship of any other god or goddess, including the Queen of Heaven, was condemned. Deceitfully promoting a zodiac in place of constellations. In this segment, we cover two elements, which sadly go hand in hand. History our Creator has given, and the history of the mendacities of history. Please understand this, it is the victor, who writes the history books, then the researcher suffers the loss of true history. In addition to history written by the victors, there are those who further butcher the lies the victor originally wrote. Now the researcher has what the Roman Church desires, zero truths. Professor of Media Studies Mark Crispin Miller once said, Media manipulation in the US today is more efficient than it was in Nazi Germany, because here we have the pretense that we are getting all the information we want. That misconception prevents people from even looking for the truth. 1981, early February. CIA Director William Casey made the statement, We'll know our disinformation program is complete when everything the American public believes is false. Creating a disinformation agenda. It has always been the desire of the atheistic elite, the entire world to lose sight of our Creator. This is more apparent today than ever before. Sadly, in the midst of the smoke screens, we have lost sight of the fact they are winning the battle. Simply look at the numbers of college graduates believing in evolution today. From the opening moments of this earth, many have been attempting to remove, manipulate, and at least alter the recorded pages of Scripture in an attempt to remove a Creator from the minds of all. Today this manipulation is taking place openly, not only by large publishing houses, but also sadly by those seeking a dime's worth of recognition as they openly rewrite the already rewritten/manipulated text. They then proudly and authoritatively proclaim their work to be restored Hebrew text. These individuals only further the campaign of butchering our Creator's original words. Further and further the cycle of deception grows out of control. Remember the statement in Scripture, the lying pens of the scribes? It is not only the lying pens of the victors, but it is also those who rewrite what they call restored Hebrew text or who qualify for the title the lying pens of the scribes. People need to stop second-guessing the words of our Creator and leave things alone. Original Paleo-Hebrew does not change, only the lies concerning rewritten by others. Please, throw your electronic devices in the trash. I can only ask you repeatedly. Get outdoors daily, look into the heavens during daylight hours, twilight, as well as nighttime. Learn the moon's waxing and waning position only by observation. Get off this garbage online and handheld apps some are saying is okay to use, look into the heavens. The story the starry bodies proclaim will soon become second nature during the different times of the year. It is like this. In order to be a baseball player, you will need to pick up a baseball and a bat to play the game. They do not play or promote the game by playing thumb games sitting in front of a computer. The same goes for those claiming to be a lunar solar Sabbath keeper. Throw away those childish apps and get outside. If you do, you will also learn and understand the problems with phases such as the first visible crescent, and the dark moon as a new moon. Maslow, spiritualism practiced in Babylonian. Much of the imagery of the constellations has its origins with the Babylonian state. In this segment, we will explore the Maseroth. The Maseroth is not of the stars, but groupings of stars embedded within its portrayed image. Concerning King Josiah. 2 Kings 23:5 And he put out of business the foreign god priests, whom the kings of Judah had put in that they might make sacrificial smoke on the high places in the cities of Judah and the surroundings of Jerusalem, and also those making sacrificial smoke to Baal, to the sun and to the moon and to the constellations of the zodiac and to all the army of the heavens. The words rendered, constellations of the zodiac are derived from, as best they know, the Hebrew word mazalov, occurring once in scripture. It is believed the imagery of astrology, we call constellations today, began here. This was a practice in Babylonian worship, used to make forecasts/interpretations based on position of the zodiac. It was, and still is, spiritualism, false worship condemned by Yahuwah. Isaiah accurately foretold that her spiritism would not save Babylon from destruction. Isaiah 47 13-15. You have grown weary with the multitude of your advisors. Let them stand up now and save you, those who worship the heavens, who gaze at the stars, those giving out knowledge at the new moons about the things that will come upon you. Look! They are like stubble. A fire will burn them up. They cannot save themselves from the power of the flame. These are not charcoals for keeping warm, and this is not a fire to sit in front of. So your charmers will become to you, those with whom you toiled from your youth. They will wander, each one in his own direction. There will be no one to save you. The unpredictable new year must be announced from Jerusalem.
Let there be lights in the expanse of the sky to separate the day from the night. Let them, the lights, be for signs to indicate seasons and days and years.
Yet others have stated, it is only a special group given the authority to make the call. This group located in the city of Jerusalem in order to, not only locate the false first visible crescent each month, are also to analyze a very unpredictable barley harvest which scripture in no way refers to as being a part of the criteria for beginning a new year. The logic applied to beginning a new year is the recurring problem of beginning a month with a first visible crescent. If sightings were supposed to take place by a group of authorized moon gazers located in Jerusalem, how long do you think it would take the moon express riders to reach all four corners of the earth proclaiming a new month has commenced, or in this case, a new year? In other words, the moon was created to be visible worldwide for the entire world to witness. What might one do if a family were thousands of miles away from Jerusalem and any phased moon was announced there? It would take months to reach the entire world. Would it not make more sense for each soul on the face of this earth to understand the motions of the moon, then wherever they are on earth they themselves would have the ability to make the call as to when our Father's Sabbaths are to take place? This is why when the moon covers the earth, everyone witnesses the exact same thing and can individually know for sure without having to wait for a messenger from thousands of miles away. You can hear it now, the bickering when to begin a year will be over when Joe's crop, versus Alan's crop, versus Harry's crop of barley has ripened. This is exactly why we are given the clear blanket of signs in the heavens all year long. History clearly demonstrates, men have fought many battles in its quest to claim superiority over others. I believe we can conclude this is why the calendar was placed in the heavens where the luminaries themselves could never be manipulated. Yet sadly, today due to the lying pens of the scribes in addition to those who share these messages concerning the luminaries, have deemed themselves the privileged ones to rewrite scriptures as they see fit. Haven't the scriptures been manipulated enough? What we believe constitutes a new year. We believe this is so simple, folks. We believe it is all, as a whole, of the magnificent, extensive, telling signs in the stars, which constitutes a new year. What each of us needs to acknowledge is, every evening just after dark, all his praiseworthy work are hemmed in a blanket. Billions of illuminated stories speak softly of the handiwork of our Creator, expressing to those who would have an eye to see, knowing he will again share why he has placed them where they are. We must remember, the stars of the heavens were taught. Simply because our minds today have not the desire/ability to learn as they had once been learned, does not give us the right today to single out a single star, a cluster of stars, shadows on the ground, or the shape/orientation of a crescent moon. This gives us no right to tell others this is what scripture teaches. That is a very dangerous path to assume. Although there are no direct texts within the context of a few verses, which provide a complete description as to when a new year begins, I would suggest, here a little, there a little applies. 1. We can be sure Moses was not shown images similar to what man has fabricated today. 2. What we have is the first Passover recorded following Exodus 12. Archaeological evidence demonstrates this took place in the spring of the year during the month of Abib. 3. Is there, at this time of year, a specific cluster of stars, which traverse across the heavens from east to west? Yes, there are. If you go out of doors at the date of this video, or one lunar year later, you will see the familiar groupings traversing overhead just after nightfall. No, we are not going to tell you which ones, Get outside and look. These familiar stars are overhead for some time. 4. We believe our Heavenly Father has placed the stars in motion as a whole. As they traverse through the heavens each month, they announce a new monthly glory for the entire world to witness, revealing the knowledge for the time of year it is. 5. Is there a crop of barley anywhere in the world that might consider a 13th lunar month? I thought not. Therefore, we need to dump that idea. 6. Should we look for any one specific star amongst the billions? Or alternatively the heavens as a whole? 7. The moon under the feet of a woman? That does not always occur. We do know a new year begins with a new moon. In other words, months must be completed. There are familiar patterns in the heavens such as Orion now, then later the Pleiades can easily be located. We believe the never-changing historical, multiple glorious clusters of stars on display every year in the spring are the true sign in which to begin a year. We believe it is apparent over the centuries, publishers of all types have eliminated, added, and altered text resulting in the desire to remove a creator from the minds of humanity. We believe the opening narrative of Exodus 12 was once complete, thoroughly describing a complete and descriptive explanation for the beginning of a new year. None other is as important as keeping our Creator's correct Sabbaths, this He has made clear. Please leave your thoughts/comments if this was helpful. Please subscribe and click the like button.